only from Sealy.
I'm not comfortable with this.
Thank you, Chet. We're back. You know, it's hard to find at the end of a season. All the baseball players go off and lie down and take a nap someplace. And so it was kind of hard to find George Stone when we wanted to get him on. And we'd like to thank Sports Illustrated because they know where everybody is and how to find them. And so we'd like to thank you, gentlemen, for helping us have George on the program. Okay, would our next challenger enter and sign in, please? Wendy Winstead. Where are you from?
Originally from Oklahoma, now New York City.
Okay, panel. Wendy Winstead organized a club for people interested in the same thing. And we will now show you what they're all interested in. And let's begin the questioning with Gene Shalit.
Well, if the purpose of the club is that they're all interested in Wendy, I want to join. This is a club interested, is it by any stretch of imagination, can it be called a hobby, what they're interested in, their joint interest?
No.
Really. One down and nine to go, Arlene.
Are they interested in a specific kind of occupation?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Soupy.
Are they interested in any particular kind of feature of a person?
No.
I mean, like maybe because you have long, beautiful hair, it's a club where you all go there and comb each other's hair.
No.
Now we know what Soupy does in
there. Or at least one of the things Soupy does. Three down, seven to go, Lois.
Is the interest in anything which has to do with your relationships to other people in some way?
No.
Four down and six to go, Gene.
This is a club of people with a common interest.
And right.
The common interest is other than the way they make their living?
Yes.
So it is an avocation, this interest, this common
interest. No, we established that it was not a hobby. Go ahead.
Well, I mean, it's not their vocation.
Right.
Okay. When the member, do the members of this club actually meet? It's
yes.
Not like a fan club, which people just have.
Yes,
they actually
they
come together and meet.
Yes.
Are both men and women members of your club?
Yes.
When they meet, do they meet in somebody's home?
No, we meet in a store, actually.
Thanks a lot. Where are you going? Wait a minute.
He said, do they meet in somebody's home? And he
I know guys that live in stores.
You know guys who live over the store.
That's right.
They're interested in a thing. I'll help you that far as long as she said store. But that really isn't too much of a help either.
No.
Arlene?
Is the thing that you're all interested in animate?
Yes.
Is it anything in the animal kingdom?
Yes, it is.
Is it a four-legged animal?
Yes.
Is it an animal that would be around the home ever?
Sometimes, yes.
Sometimes they are around the home, Arlene. Largely in this case is because they're interested in them. Sometimes they're around the home, but it's an accident when they are. You would not ordinarily expect to find them around
a skunk.
That's
skunk.
Right. Well, that was 6.5 down and 4.5 to go. That's right. Wendy started a club for the owners of pet skunks. Wendy, at the risk of looking like a fool, why did you do that?
Well, I knew a lot of people who had skunks, and they were kind of hard to take care of, so we got together, and we just sort of exchange solutions to different problems we have with them.
Do they make good pets?
Not terribly good pets, no. For somebody who's got a lot of time and a lot of patience and doesn't mind getting bit now and then, they're nice pets.
Oh, unruly.
Why do you have a pet like that?
Why do you have them?
Well, they're very, very lovable, really.
Are they?
You spend the time with them.
Did you bring one?
As a matter of fact, I brought a very lovable little skunk with me. Sally Michael, wake up and say hello.
Now, she's been deodorant, has she not?
Yes, she has. Would you like something to eat?
Now, what's her little name? Boy, she's got some pair of teeth. I'd hate to get bitten by those.
No, she did.
How old is she?
She's about 6 months old. She's full grown, though.
What does she eat?
She eats anything. Dog food, cat food, table scraps. There's hardly anything she won't eat.
How long do skunks live?
Generally about 6 or 7 years, I think. Okay.
Yeah, I see you've had her declawed.
Yeah, for...
She can eat everything, probably.
Almost.
At what point is she disarmed, as they say?
At about 5 weeks of age, mm-hmm. Very early.
Is that a very complicated operation?
It's very simple if you know what you're doing.
Can you train them to come and sit and lie down and roll over? Or?
She comes when I call her, fairly much. She follows me around a lot in the house, though. Mostly she's under my feet, so I don't have to call her.
Do they get around with other animals, get along with other animals?
Some do and some don't. She happens to hate other animals. She's very jealous. Mm-hmm. I got her before she opened her eyes and bottle fed her. And every time the cat walks by, she bites it if she's around me.
What a wonderful pet to have around. Thank you for being with us.
That's my eye, Wendy. That's
lovely. We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message.
Answer. If you're not satisfied with your current treatment program, call this very important phone number toll-free. At Cancer Treatment Centers of America, we offer leading-edge medical technology.
He's dying. Something's happened to his brain. Electrical activity decreasing.
It's too late, Captain Kirk. In a few minutes, your friend will be gone. But as Caniculus One lives on in each of his clones, so will Mr. Spock. Behold, gentlemen, the dawning of a new era, the salvation of a galaxy, Spock 2.
WKRP on Nick at Night with Howard Hessman.
That's right, kids. Nick at Night, the place for TV hits, is putting WKRP back on the air. Jennifer, Herb, Venus, Les, Andy, Bailey, the big guy, and of course, Dr. Johnny Fever are back in a mega KRP marathon. I'll be your host, spinning the platters that matter, playing your favorite WKRP hits. So gig it, babies!
The WKRP marathon starts Monday, July 5th at 9, 8 Central on Nick at Night.
Polly has a pogo stick. She wants to meet her new neighbor, Ned. Look at Polly bounce. Yum! Ned is eating a garden burger lunch. So are the Watsons. They are healthy and tasty and good. Polly's getting hungry. Look! Garden burger in first class. Cosmonauts. Grandma? Discover garden burger. All natural, really tasty. End of story. Because eating good just got great.
I have a brief but interesting message for you about Kellogg's cereal packages. You know the big ones. Kellogg's new ideal shape, big on the inside, a comfortable size outside, easy to handle and fit in the cupboard. But do you know the one-serving packages? The individual open when you're ready and eat it now, always fresh, always handy, one bowl full at a timers, kind of cute. And in assortments, a six-pack of Kellogg's Ready Sweetened Cereals, the favorite of kids and of some other folks, called Kellogg's Snack Pack. Six-pack of cereals adults ask for most, called Request Pack. Eight of a single kind. Not all Kellogg's cereals come this way, but you'll find some of your favorites, called Kellogg's Handy Pack. An assortment of 10 packs, a little something for everybody, called Kellogg's Variety. An assortment of 18 packs, a little something for more than everybody, called Kellogg's Jumbo Assortment. Watch for them.
Hang on tight as TVLand goes west with this classic western starring David Carradine. Shane is coming at you next.
Get ready.
The chemical sprayer is empty.
Mine too, Jim.
Wait. Listen.
Maybe they're waiting for the mist to clear. Well, how about that? Great-granddaddy's weed spray still works.
Never mind that. We've got to get Spock out of here before Caniculus returns.
Scott should have the Enterprise back by now. Kirk to Enterprise. Kirk to Enterprise. Nothing. Must be these blasted walls again. Kirk to Enterprise.
It's no use, Jim. He'll be dead in a few minutes. His mind is gone. He no longer thinks. This machine has drained his mind somehow.
More than just drained. It's been transferred. Relocated into the mechanism itself. Just as my predecessor transferred his knowledge to me through this apparatus, I have done that with Mr. Spock, and the first...